Have you ever experienced this feeling where you've heard a particular word or fact thrown around in public or a random song lyric that you just can't get out of your head and you need to know more? You can't rest until you know exactly what it is. For me, this was physiology. You know how in the movie Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince, Harry pretends to give Ron a potion called Liquid Luck, saying that it will help him be a better keeper at the upcoming Quidditch game. But Ron somehow plays better than anticipated without the effects of that potion. What if I told you that I could do the same with a pill? Well, that is exactly the manner in which I wish to explain my version of the placebo effect. Before we get to the topic at hand, some of you may be wondering, what is a placebo? To enlighten my audience, a placebo is a substance or a treatment that has no therapeutic effects, often used as a control in testing new drugs. It can also be in the form of treatments such as sham surgeries. Now, if I continue explaining about the placebo effect, it would be plagiarism. Unfortunately, someone else thought ahead of me and even made a video on it. So I thought, what if I dug a little deeper than the guy who made that video on placebos? That is what brought me to the present moment. I am going to talk about what else placebos can do other than help in medical treatments. The human mind is full of surprises. When we find one way into tricking our minds, like the placebo effect, our intellect gives us insight into how it can be developed in such a way that it unlocks certain mysteries about the human body. We can see that placebos play an effective role in releasing hormones like adrenaline, testosterone, and such others during medical treatments to relieve patients from excruciating pain. What we don't know is that the same placebos can be used to enhance human capabilities in various circumstances. I think this would better be explained using an example. When students find it hard to study, they usually blame themselves or their surroundings. Some take this inability to study less seriously than others and don't try to find alternative surroundings. For this group of people, we can conduct an experiment by providing a pill with no medical effects on the consumer. Before consumption, we would tell our consumers, this pill can give you the ability to remove disturbances in your surroundings and enable each of you with enhanced concentration. Equipped with this belief, they ingest the pill, they get back to their study environment and see if they came across any changes. And surprisingly, many will come across a positive externality with heightened concentration skills. This is because the placebo does not medically affect the consumer, but helps elevate the person on a physiological level. It induces the production of hormones like dopamine, which is also called the motivation molecule, and helps the user to finish his or her tasks in the most productive way. Just like the above example, placebos can be used in situations where people undermine their abilities. We just don't know what we are capable of, but we do have an idea on how we can unlock said unknown gifts. I could give a bunch of ineffective pills to people undergoing depression and tell them that it would reduce the dark thoughts and anxiety within them. And with the help of their belief, they would be able to, they could potentially release themselves from physical and mental suffering. Thoughts are pathways to action. This cheesy quote can relate to what the placebo effect does to our body. We think that any problem, medical or physiological, can be cured using medication. What we don't know is that it is our mind that does half the work and lets us think that these drugs have a monumental effect on our body. Why don't we forget about the industry of medicine and focus on daily life situations? As humans, we face challenges concerning both the body and the mind. I'm not saying that a pill can cure all your difficulties, but it can definitely give them a kickstart and motivate them to, at the very least, or think about giving it a try to comprehend our issues and taking one step towards solving them. In conclusion, I would like to say that placebos are a great way to intercede our problems, but it is just not a necessity or the right thing to do to deal with such circumstances. Human confidence isn't something that can be inculcated into our conscience through artificial means. I'm just saying that you don't need an ineffective drug to show that there is a lot more to what we are capable of, and that we can be our own confidence boosters to uplift ourselves when it comes to facing these natural evils that we call problems. Thank you.